It's a case of who owns what and who can rightfully claim it. The interpleaded Marcos property includes paintings, jewelry, carpets, and over $15 million in funds seized from several bank accounts and several entities that are laying claim to them. These properties were seized from former Philippine First Lady Imelda Marcos's personal secretary, Vilma Bautista. Claimants include the Philippine Commission on Good Government, or PCGG, representing the Republic of the Philippines.
And we think we're going to have an opportunity to litigate the case and defend the rights of the people of the Philippines to get back that property that was stolen from them.
Next claimant is Jose Duran and the victims of human rights abuses who belong to a class action holding a judgment of close to $400 million against the estate of the Marcoses.
It didn't go procedurally the way we wanted it, but the important thing is that we're going to be able to move forward and prove that the class of human rights victims is entitled to the proceeds from the Monet painting and some other paintings.
Other claimants include individuals from whom the said properties were seized, such as Bautista and her sisters, Imelda Marcos herself, the Metropolitan Museum of Manila Foundation, and Bautista's attorney, George Ramos, who is also an artist that claims he owns 8 of the paintings seized by the DA from the Bautista's residences. The New York District Attorney is now searching for the rightful owner of the property. In a continuing hearing at Courtroom 618 at the Thurgood Marshall U.S. Courthouse Thursday, Judge Catherine Polk-Vela granted the DA's request to deposit the interpleaded property in the registry of the U.S. District Court for the Southern District of New York. Swift said, the biggest challenge that is preventing the group of human rights victims to collect payment is the Philippine government itself.
The Philippine courts have refused to recognize our judgment in the Philippines, and they've refused to give comity to the U.S. courts. It's frankly extraordinary. You'd expect it from North Korea or Syria or Iran, but it's, I think, highly unusual that a country like the Philippines would act this way.
The seized property are now set to be moved from Christie's and the DA's office to be deposited to the court next month. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York City, New York.